As the story goes, when physicists were asked back in the 1940s what the highest speed a wheel-driven automobile could attain in a standing start quarter-mile run, the consensus was about 150 miles per hour. Of course, someone forgot to tell drag racers that. Almost from the moment that drag racing was launched, the speeds have skyrocketed from year to year, certainly no more so than in Top Fuel. By the mid-1950s, the 150 mile per hour barrier had already been smashed to pieces. In 1964, 200 mile per hour Top Fuel top speeds became a regularity. But in the minds of the great majority of Top Fuel racers, 300 miles per hour in the quarter mile represented the most glorious of achievements waiting to be claimed. As the 1992 season began, nothing had happened at the first two races that indicated that the 300 mile per hour barrier was in any imminent jeopardy. Kenny Bernstein won the year's first race, the Winter Nationals, beating Jim Head with a 496 at 281 miles per hour. The next race in Phoenix was won by Pat Austin over Doug Herbert with a 506 at 286 miles per hour. But the next race was at the super quick Gainesville Raceway, and the upcoming 1992 Gator Nationals was beginning to take on some added significance.
When everybody was running 295 miles an hour, 298, I think there were quite a few of the better teams that were really trying to be the first to go 300. And people were, the crew chiefs were working feverishly to be that team, and it was like maybe one of the last great benchmarks on the wall.
On Saturday, March 20th, 1992, Kenny Bernstein and the Bud King Top Fuel Dragster were about to make what was thought to be a run at the number one qualifying position for Sunday eliminations. As the Bud King prepared to leap from the starting line, drag racing history was about to be made. Something that Kenny Bernstein was no stranger to, having become only the second man in NHRA history to win four consecutive Winston Funny Car titles between 1985 and 1988. This time, the scoreboards recorded one of the all-time great performances in drag racing, and Bernstein achieved a mark that had been coveted by everyone who had ever competed in a Top Fuel dragster, the sport's first 300 mile per hour speed.
What a deal. I'm speechless. I mean, unbelievable. Dale, Wes, the Budweiser King team, you can't say enough about them. They just keep coming at it. 300 miles an hour, I can't believe it.
301.
It's a dream come true, believe me. I can't say enough about NHRA and the preparation of the racetrack. It took perfect conditions to do it, believe me. I can't believe this.
Bernstein would go on to record another drag racing first in 1996 when he won the Winston Top Fuel title, becoming the first racer to win championships in both nitro categories. In 1999, he celebrated another drag racing milestone, his 20th anniversary with his primary sponsor, Anheuser-Busch. But in a career that has been underscored with tumultuous victories and thrilling successes, Kenny Bernstein's 301.70 mile per hour pass in Gainesville, Florida in the spring of 1992 remains his most resounding accomplishment.